So at this point, we have talked quite a bit about requirements engineering, but we haven't really discussed what are requirements exactly. So what is a requirement? To define that, I'm going to use this diagram, which is a classical one. So you might have seen it before. So discussing this diagram allows me to point out a few interesting things about requirements and define them in a better way. At a high level, this diagram contains two main parts: the domain of the machine, which is the hardware, operating system, libraries, and so on which the software will run, and the domain of the application, which is the world in which the software will operate. And the machine domain is characterized by computers, which are the hardware devices, and programs, which is the software that runs on these devices. The application domain, conversely, is characterized by domain properties, which are things that are true of the world anyways, whether I'm building my system or not, and requirements, which are things in the world we would like to achieve by delivering the system that we are building. Basically, to put it in a different way, the former, the domain properties, represent the assumptions that we make on the domain, and the latter, the requirements, are the actual requirements that we aim to collect. So we have something here, right, at the intersection of this application domain and machine domain. And what is that? And this is what we normally call the specification, which is a description, often a formal description, of what the system that we are building should do to meet the requirements. So this is a bridge between these two domains. And as the graphical depiction shows, the specification is written in terms of shared phenomena, things that are observable in both the machine domain and the application domain. And just to make things a little more concrete, I want to give you a couple of examples of what these phenomena, these shared phenomena, are. And we can think about two main kinds of phenomena. The first one are events in the real world that the machine can directly sense. For example, a button being pushed or a sensor being activated. These are events that happen here, but that the machine can detect. So they're events that can be used to define the specification. And the second type of phenomena are actions in the real world that the machine can directly cause. For example, an image appearing on the screen or a device being turned on and off. Again, this is something that the machine can make happen and then can have manifestation in the real world. And again, this is therefore something on which the specification can predicate, something that we can describe in our specification. And this is sort of a philosophical discussion. But even if you don't care about the philosophical discussion, the one takeaway point that I would like for you to get from this discussion is the fact that when writing a specification, you have to be aware of the fact that you're talking about shared phenomena. Events in the real world that the machine can sense and actions in the real world that the machine can cause. So this is what the specification is about. A bridge between these two worlds that define what the systems should do to satisfy the requirements.